As I mentioned, here's the end result. Baba, I have a losing trade, and CGC is nice winner that was a short. Cisco tried to go long fade. TLRY, good trade, and then two trades in TPR. End result is $1,400, almost 15. Let's take a quick look at some of the trades here so we can discuss them. Let's start with Baba. Look, Baba was the right thing to do. We went long over 168. That's a whole number. We should go long over whole numbers, and that was a beautiful setup here, which failed. How do I know it failed? Well, first, my account shows that, and second, just take a look at the chart here. Look at this topping tail here. It moved up nicely, although my target was $1 as my risk. So you see, it moved up by 44 cents, and then the same candle actually turned to be red, and then it continued coming down. The first was a spike, then it come down a bit, and then the stop was just under 167, same as my target. We could know that there was a $1 stop loss because of this spike down here. That was close to 167, and of course that's a whole number, so you put your stop under a whole number. So that was a loser. That was my last trade. And I calculated my quantity in a way that I traded 800 shares because I knew that if I'm going to have a loser, it's going to be approximately $800. In fact, it's $900. And that's going to be approximately a third of my income today. So I was up $2,400, just came down 15, and that's because of Baba. So there was nothing wrong about Baba. The market at that time was trending higher. So you see, we took Baba somewhere over here when the market refused to move lower, came up, and Baba, of course, is up today. So everything was ticking correctly. Market was trending higher. Baba is up 3%. Baba was trending higher. That was the right trade to take. Nothing wrong about that. Just that not all of our trades are profitable. Nothing we can do about that. Let's take a look at CGC. So I posted CGC on the Twitter. Yes, right now I remember this trade. So CGC started with a very big gap down. It's down 9%, which is approximately the way it started today. And then initial move, how to say, second move was up very clearly, but you wait for stocks like that to fail. And therefore, when it came under 29, I posted it in the room, and then it came down. Gave us plenty of space to make a profit. And now it's just going sideways. I'm out, but that was a $2,000 trade. And you know, when the stock is down 9% and then moves under the lows, and usually it cracks down a bit more because there's a lot of fear going on. Stock is already down 9% and then continues down. A lot of volume takes it down. Plenty of space to get a good partial and you know, to put the risk behind. And although it moved up, finally it was a nice trade. Then came the Cisco trade. Now Cisco is a big company. People love to buy it when it's down. Stock is down 7% right now, which is again approximately the way it started. And you can see that it came down initially, then moved up. I was looking to go long, and I posted in the room over 47.70. And then initially it moved up. My target was around 25 cents. It came very close. Actually, it came 24 cents. So it came to 94. I was looking for just a few more cents to put the risk behind me. And I thought that since it's a big company, people love to buy it when it's up. But since it's a big risk, you don't take too much risk. When it came down 20 cents, I was out. So that turned out to be a relatively small loser. Smaller size to start with because I was taking going long a stock that is down 7%. I did do that because, again, people love to buy big companies when they're down. Cisco certainly is a big company, but I just wasn't lucky enough. And of course, it came down then. So that was a losing trade in Cisco. Let's take a look at TLRY. Same idea. Stock is down 8% right now. It wasn't 8% when we started out with that one, but take a look at the way it behaved. Trying to move higher and failing. Big gap down, 8% right now. So maybe it was 6 or something like that earlier. And then I believe I posted it under 37.30. Yeah, I remember that now. So once I made sure it's not, it's trying to move under the lows, that was where I posted it, and look at this beautiful move. I did not manage it correctly. I should have managed it a bit better because it came down and continued to come down, and I took my partial a bit too early with TLRY, but that was still a nice winner. Now, TPR had two trades. Here's TPR, I had two trades. The first one right over here, just like I usually do. And again, stock that is down 19% right now, tried to move higher, failed. Should have shorted it, did short it, did not work out. Moved up, took me out. Then, when we noticed it's coming down again, we shorted it again, 21.10, added under 21. I'm still riding 100 shares, that's all. Second trade was a lovely trade, but my first trade was a bit bigger loser than my second trade, so I'm still down $500 in TPR. So I'm okay, almost $1,500. That's my fourth consecutive green day for the week. And I'm not going to continue trading today because I think that my best trades were probably done by now. And if I'm going to continue trading, that's going to be kind of compromised. And if I had a big profit cushion, like if I was over $3,000, let's say my last trade in Bubba would have worked, something like that, I guess I probably could have taken another two trades with small size, but I don't really want to do that now. I will keep my $1,500 and be done with it, be happy with a fourth consecutive green trade, green day. I don't see the market taking up to new highs now. It keeps going sideways, did touch a new high. I don't see a perfect setup that I would like to take right now. And I'll hear your advice. Well, 64% of you said I shouldn't continue trading.